Well, I want to talk about conversation because it could be the most radical collaboration we have. Yes. My first experience with the power of conversation was in the 60s when I went to the South to work in the civil rights movement. And I went to a place called Highlander, where Rosa Parks had been trained. And Highlander was famous in the South for the work it did in civil rights. And what did they do that was so extraordinary that they were famous? They brought people together to talk. They brought people together because they felt deeply that when people have a chance to talk about their problems and their issues, they will make the changes. And that changed my life. And my second experience that I had with people in conversation was during the early women's movement in the consciousness-raising groups. And we would get together every week, and we would talk and talk and talk and talk about everything in our lives, and then we went out and started a movement. And so I could see that I really cared about this form of social change, and so I started starting study groups myself, and one of my friends said to me one day, "Cecile, you're doing it again, another small group. You know, what are you? What were you in another life? A sheepdog?" And I'm beginning to think, well, yes, how nice to know my essential nature. I was a sheepdog. And so I kept trying all through the years of figuring out what was so special about bringing people together to talk. And I was searching for this. And then a new idea popped up, and it just went around, just around the world. And when you see something like that happen, you have to ask, well, what was it that was going on there? Well, it was the slow food movement. And what they were saying was, you shouldn't be sitting alone at night, eating your TV dinner in the dark, night after night. That when you have dinner, you should be with friends and family and talking and appreciating each other and enjoying yourselves. And I thought when I saw that, well, this is it. This is it. It's the vision of a joyful community. This is what people want. They want to come together. They want to appreciate each other. They want to laugh together. And they want to love each other. And so I thought, how do we get the word on this around? And so I thought, I'll make up a model for people to use in their small groups. And it's essentially three questions. Anybody can use it, no training necessary. And it's about any subject you can want to talk about, but let's say it's collaboration. So the first question is, when in your life have you experienced collaboration? And so people tell their personal stories. This is what's so important about telling your story. You connect with other people. And all the research on happiness shows that connection with other people is the primary factor. So in the first question, you connect. And then the second question is, what in our society keeps us from collaborating? And this is really the critical thinking question, but we want this to be a congenial critical thinking, not shooting down each other's ideas. We live in an argument society, and people are hesitant now to discuss ideas because they're afraid they're going to be attacked. And so we've got to take back and relearn this congenial conversation. And the third question has to do with what action should I take? You talk it over with your other circle members, and you think, well, I'll go out and do this, and you try it. And you come back, and you talk about it again. And what you realize is that in this setting, the support you get, the feeling that people are on your side. So often in this culture, we feel people are critical and are judgmental. But here you really, really feel supported, and that makes all the difference. So I like this method of social change. This conversation method, because the reason is it looks so benign. It looks so harmless. Who would know we were part of a revolution? And I think of it as a living room revolution, creating a joyful, joyful community and a caring and collaborative culture. Now, the break is coming up in a minute, and I want you to commit to snag somebody on your way out and ask them about their experiences of collaboration. And never doubt that a small group can change the world. Thank you. Thank you.